we're chasing this big story about the takeover of ABS-CBN's broadcast frequencies by a company owned by former senator and billionaire Manny Villar. Our correspondent Warren de Guzman tells us what we have so far. Good morning, Warren. Thank you so much for joining us. So what's the score? What's happening here?
Well, good morning, Michelle. The National Telecommunications Commission has granted the use of two frequencies formerly held by ABS-CBN, our parent network, to Advanced Media Broadcasting System, or AMBS Incorporated, which is linked to billionaire and former politician Manny Villar. The NTC says an order promulgated on January 5th of this year granted AMBS a provisional authority to operate a digital television broadcasting system in Metro and Mega Manila using Channel 16, which ABS-CBN had previously used to run Studio 23. NTC says AMBS was the first applicant for an authority to install, operate, and maintain a digital TV in Metro Manila with its application filed on October 5th, 2006. And it has been waiting since 2006 for an available digital frequency. The NTC also allowed AMBS to use an analog channel, Channel 2, also previously held by ABS-CBN. The NTC says the use of Channel 2 by AMBS is temporary and will last only until all analog channels are shut off, and that is scheduled for 2023 as part of the Philippines' full transition into digital television. The NTC also shared a copy of the order, and based on the order, AMBS has a total assets of about 35.7 million pesos, with just 1.6 million pesos in liabilities and 34 million pesos in equity. AMBS had quoted the setup of its digital TV broadcast station would cost around 28.5 million pesos. Villar's net worth is estimated by Forbes at around $7.3 billion, or roughly 373 billion pesos, including interests in listed companies such as property developer Vista Land and Lifescapes, retailers All Homes and Vista Malls, and the growing water utility company Prime Water. Forbes says he is the second richest in the Philippines behind only the C siblings of SM. We've reached out to the Villar family for comment. They have yet to respond. Michelle?
Hi, Warren. Two quick questions. Number one, what does this fundamentally mean for ABS-CBN, or is this a non-issue already? And secondly, when ABS-CBN does, you know, what do we do next? Are we going to apply for different frequencies? Are there available other available frequencies to apply since these two are taken already?
Just based on the NTC order, you see that the Villar company had applied for the setup of a digital broadcast company in 2006, and it took them a while to get a frequency. They had to wait for ABS-CBN to be shut down. So that tells you about the scarcity of this asset. Again, ABS-CBN was shut down. We no longer control these, or we no longer have the right to use these frequencies. We're running exclusively online now. So that doesn't affect the operations of ABS-CBN at this point. The question you asked regarding whether or not we'll have frequencies once we renew our franchise to operate on free TV, that's something altogether. We're going to have to wait, just like the Villars did, as the NTC said in its statement.
Or we could also get into partnerships.
That's true. Other business organizations have been able to get into broadcast through those means. Acquisition or partnership, that's all on the table. We really need to figure out first what the Villars want to do with this. But there was some news out that they plan on actually setting up and broadcasting even from one of their malls in EDSA. So at least that's one of the what the document showed. So we'll wait and see what they do with this bit of news from the NTC.
All right. On that note, Warren, thank you so much for joining us today.